This video is going to look at the Mymathlab links that you find interspersed all throughout your Blackboard course. For instance, if I were to go to the Classroom menu item on the left and navigate to any one of these units, say Unit 2, you'll find these different Mymathlab links throughout this particular unit. For instance, in the Mymathlab assignment folder, you see a link in here to the Mymathlab homework webpage. Go back to the multimedia folder, and you see links there to the Mymathlab Multimedia Library and the Mymathlab Pearson eText, that is the virtual textbook for this class. Now, both of these different options have their own videos talking a little bit more about them, so please definitely go take a look at those to get a better understanding of how those options work. And then also, at the end of the unit, in the unit test folder, you have a link to the Mymathlab testing page. So all throughout this site, you are going to be finding these Mymathlab links. However, in order for these links to all work, the first thing you're going to need to do at the beginning of the semester is under the Start Here menu item, there's a folder labeled Mymathlab Setup. That's going to give you instructions on how to integrate the Blackboard course with your Mymathlab course. And you'll need to be able to register with Mymathlab during this time, so you will need an access code that came with the book, or you'll need to purchase access with a credit card. There is another video describing about registering with Mymathlab, so please also take a look at that. But once you have registered with Mymathlab and linked it with this Blackboard course, then all Mymathlab links in Blackboard will actually be live. That is, clicking on that will send you right to the Mymathlab website. As a convenience, though, over on the left, I do have a menu item labeled Mymathlab Links, and clicking on that basically gives you a list of the different Mymathlab links you'll find in this course. Now, the first one of these, the Mymathlab with Pearson eText Course Home, basically just sends you to the homepage of the Mymathlab site. This is the same page you'd see if you logged into Mymathlab using your Mymathlab username and password. Here on the left, you can navigate to any part of the Mymathlab website you want to. Of particular note, though, on this page is the link to the browser check. That's something you are going to be able to do when you first sign up with Mymathlab. Run through that just to make sure that your computer will work seamlessly with the Mymathlab site. There's also the How to Enter Answers tutorial, which is going to be very useful. That's going to explain how to enter different sort of mathematical symbols in both your Mymathlab homework and on your Mymathlab tests. This way you don't get a wrong answer because you just wrote it in there wrong. Anyway, there's also this link to the Pearson Tutor Services, where if you're needing some help with Mymathlab, that's definitely something to take advantage of. So that's the home page. We've already talked a little bit about the Mymathlab homework page in another video, but that's what that would send you to. Now here there's no homework assigned yet, so you don't see anything, but when there is homework assigned, you'll see links to the individual homeworks. There's the testing page, and on this page, you do see the practice test that's available. That's something you do need to do at the very beginning of the semester. But you'll also see all these sample tests. These are preloaded in Mymathlab. These are not for grading purposes. Whenever a test is out there for grading purposes, it will be listed in this section up at the top of the page. So when the test becomes available, you'll see it there. If you want to try some of these other tests for practice, that is fine, but they are not mandatory. Only what you're going to see appear in the assigned test section. There's also the Mymathlab Multimedia Library. That's, again, described in another video, as is the Mymathlab eText. And then this is just a direct link to your Mymathlab browser check, which you already talked about as well. Again, something you do want to run through just to make sure your computer and the Mymathlab site work well together. So that's a little description of the Mymathlab links that you'll find in Blackboard. Again, if you have any questions on any of this or are experiencing any problems, please feel free to email me or call so that we can work out any issues before any major assignment is due.